A very good morning, dear students. Welcome to my channel, Maths with Mahanti sir. Children, in the last class, we were discussing how to find surface area and volume of a sphere and hemisphere, where I discussed everything in detail. What is sphere, what is hemisphere, how to find their surface area and volume, etc. So today let us discuss another important solid, three-dimensional solid, known as your spherical cell. What is a spherical cell and how to find its what? Total surface area, volume, etc. Okay, see, your spherical cell is another three-dimensional solid. Children, you have the idea of concentric circles, and also I had discussed the concept of concentric circles while discussing the surface area and volume of your hollow cylinder or pipe. In hollow cylinder or pipe, at the top and the bottom, there are two rims, and each rim is nothing but two concentric circles. You know what are concentric circles? Two or more than two circles having same center but different radii are called concentric circles. Now you see, this your spherical cell, look at, this is the figure of a spherical cell, just you see, this is a spherical cell, look at the center. Now suppose this is outer radius, this is inner radius, okay, this outer radius, inner radius be small r, this outer radius be capital R, you see. So we can say that spherical cell is nothing but a three-dimensional solid, which is, that means two concentric solid spheres, not concentric circles, solid spheres, because we are considering what? We are discussing about spherical cell, means it is a part of sphere, okay. So spherical cell is what? It is made up of two concentric solid spheres. Actually, whatever sphere we discussed, sphere, total, so sphere has a curved surface in the last class I discussed. Sphere has only one curved surface, and its surface area, curved surface area is same as total surface area, which is equal to 4 pi r square, where r is the radius of the sphere, okay. Sphere is the set of all points in space which are equidistant from a fixed point known as the center. These are the things which we have already discussed. So by sphere we mean it is solid sphere only, okay. By sphere, whenever the term sphere comes, you will immediately understand that it is about solid sphere. So then what is spherical cell? Spherical cell is a three-dimensional solid which consists of two concentric solid spheres, okay. This is outer sphere, this is inner solid sphere, having two different radii, capital R and small r. And you see this portion is the thickness, this portion is the thickness of your spherical cell. So what is thickness? Thickness of spherical cell can be found out by the formula R minus R, capital R minus small r, means outer radius minus inner radius, or you can say radius of outer sphere, outer solid sphere minus difference of the two radii of the two concentric solid spheres will give you the thickness of what? Spherical cell. Then how can we find the outer curved surface area? You see, the outer curved surface area, outer surface area. What will be the outer surface area of this? You see, as I just told you that it consists of two concentric solid spheres. So having two radii, capital R and small r, that means outer radius and inner radius, then what will be the formula for your outer surface area of this sphere? What will be the formula for outer surface area? If you are asked to find, this is the spherical cell, if you are asked to find the outer surface area, what will be the formula? Outer surface area will be 4 pi r square. Because why? What is the reason? The reason is because this is a solid sphere. This is a solid sphere and the inner one. This is outer solid sphere, this is inner solid sphere. Okay. Which constitute your what? Spherical cell. Okay. So outer surface area of spherical cell will be 4 pi capital R square, and inner surface area will be 4 pi small r square, because each one is a solid sphere. Each sphere is a solid sphere here in your spherical cell. So outer surface area will be 4 pi capital R square, and inner your surface area will be your 4 pi small r square. And what is the formula for thickness? Thickness will be r minus r. Now if you are asked to find the volume of spherical cell, what will be the volume of spherical cell? You see, volume of spherical cell. Definitely, since the spherical cell consists of two concentric solid spheres, definitely its volume of the spherical cell will be equal to outer volume minus inner volume. Volume of the outer sphere minus volume of the inner sphere will give you volume of the spherical cell. So we can write volume of spherical cell. You know what is the formula for volume of sphere? Already we have discussed. It is 4 by 3 pi r cube, where r is the radius. Okay, 4 by 3 pi r cube or pi d cube by 6, where d is the diameter. So, volume of spherical cell means it is outer volume minus inner volume, or volume of outer sphere minus volume of inner sphere. So, it will be 4 by 3 pi capital R cube minus 4 by 3 pi small r cube. Okay, so you can take common 4 by 3 pi, it will be r cube minus r cube. Okay, so this will be the volume of your spherical cell, and this will be the formula for outer surface area of the spherical cell, and this is the thickness, and inner surface area it will be 2 pi small r square, because the inner one is also a solid sphere. Okay, so its area will be 4 pi small r square. Now what about hemispherical cell? Let us discuss about hemispherical cell. Hemispherical cell. Now what will be hemispherical? Just you join this one. Now the spherical cell has been divided into two parts. Each part is a hemispherical cell. Okay. And you know what is the formula. That means hemispherical cell, it is what? It consists of two concentric hemispheres. You see, this portion is the hemispherical cell. This portion, this diameter and this portion is the hemispherical cell. And what does it represent? This hemispherical cell represents two concentric hemispheres. And you know the formula for hemisphere. How to find surface area and volume of hemisphere, you know. So you can easily find what are different formulae on your hemispherical cell. You see. Now see, this is your outer hemisphere, this is inner hemisphere. Look at this one. This one is outer and this one is here inner. So outer surface area of hemispherical cell. So what will be the formula for outer surface area? Children, you know what is the surface area of hemisphere. Surface area of hemisphere is half the surface area of a sphere. Surface area means it is curved surface area and total surface area in case of sphere. Because in case of sphere, our sphere is a curved surface, already we have discussed. Our sphere is a curved surface, it has only what? I mean its curved surface area and total surface area are same, which is equal to 4 pi r square, already we have discussed. Now, if the curved surface area of a sphere is 4 pi r square, then what is the curved surface area of a hemisphere? It is half of 4 pi r square, means 2 pi r square. So, definitely outer surface area, this one, this area of this outer curved surface will be 2 pi capital R square. And the area of this inner curved surface, you see, it will be 2 pi small r square. So, outer surface area of hemispherical cell will be 2 pi r square, and inner surface area of hemispherical cell will be 2 pi r square. Now if I ask you, what will be the volume of hemispherical cell? You can easily answer, because you know what is the formula for volume of what? Hemisphere. Volume of hemisphere, how to find volume of hemisphere? It is 2 by 3 pi r cube. 2 by 3 pi r cube, it is the formula to find volume of hemisphere. So if 2 by 3 pi r cube is the formula to find volume of hemisphere, then in hemispherical cell, there are two concentric hemispheres. So as there are two concentric hemispheres in hemispherical cell, so the volume of hemispherical cell, how to find out? Volume of outer hemisphere minus volume of inner hemisphere. Take the difference of the volume, of the inner hemisphere and outer hemisphere, you will get the volume of what? Hemispherical cell. So I'll find out. So volume of your hemispherical cell, hemispherical cell will be equal to, definitely outer volume, find out this volume. Volume of outer hemisphere, it is 2 by 3 pi capital R cube, and volume of inner hemisphere, it is 2 by 3 pi small r cube. Now you take the difference. You take the difference. Take common 2 by 3 pi, it will be r cube minus r cube. Okay. So this is the formula to find volume of hemispherical cell. This is inner surface area of hemispherical cell. This is outer surface area of hemispherical cell. Children, with this I completed almost everything about all the three-dimensional solids as given in your NCERT syllabus of class 9. How, what are they and how to find? What are the different three-dimensional figures as given in your NCERT syllabus of class 9? I discussed everything in detail. How to find the surface area and volume of each solid? What is the formula? I discussed everything. So children, I hope you must have understood. You please remember all the formulae. Then only you will be able to apply them in problem. Okay? So today let us discuss one more problem. One problem to complete the chapter surface area and volume. Okay? Suppose, see, here is an interesting question. This question is on, this question is from your NCERT book on cone. Children, suppose you are given, see, what is cone, how a cone is generated, how to find its surface area and volume, etc. Everything I have discussed. Suppose you are given a right angle triangle, say this is 12 cm, this is 5 cm, say this is 13 cm. Suppose you are given a right triangle, say ABC, 5 cm, 12 cm and 13 cm, okay? And you are asked to revolve. Children, you already know that when we revolve, how a cone is generated? I have discussed earlier. A cone is generated when a right angle triangle, I mean one of the sides, keeping one of the sides fixed, if any other side is revolved about the fixed line, whatever solid is generated, that is called a cone. That means, suppose you are given that you will revolve this right angle triangle about this side. Look at. About the perpendicular. Suppose this is the perpendicular. About this perpendicular are 12 cm. If you revolve this right triangle about side 12 cm, so what will happen? A cone will be formed. So what will be the shape of the cone? What will be the shape of the cone? You see, you will get a solid like this. Look at. See. Once again I am saying, suppose you are given a right triangle ABC whose sides are 5, 12 and 13. Suppose you are asked to revolve this right triangle about the side AB whose length is 12 cm. Okay. So what will happen? If you revolve the right triangle about this side, you will get a solid like this. And that means you will get a cone like this. See, when it is revolved about 12 cm, now look at this 5 cm, it becomes what? It becomes, just to join this one, it becomes the radius of base, you see. So, when right triangle ABC is revolved, suppose revolved about AB equal to 12 cm, suppose. If we revolve this right triangle ABC about this fixed side, that is 12 cm, so you will get cone like this, okay? In this case, what will happen? See, the radius of base, so R will become your radius of base will be equal to BC, that is 5 cm, and what about H? Height of the cylinder. See, once again I am saying, suppose ABC is a right triangle whose sides are 5, 12 and 13. Now, if you revolve this right triangle, if you revolve triangle ABC about the side AB, that is 12 cm, what will be generated? You will get a cone like this. Okay, a cone will be formed like this. And whose height will be equal to 12 cm and radius of base will be equal to 5 cm. Okay, so H will be equal to AB, that is 12 cm. Now the question is find the volume. You can easily find the volume. So what will be the volume? So volume of cone, you know the formula? Volume of cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Now you put the value 1 by 3 pi, in place of r you put 5 square and in place of h you put 12 and you do simplification. 3, 4 is 12. 5 square is 25. 25 into 4 is 100. So you see. So 100 by cubic centimeter. Look at. So the volume of cube, volume of the cone will be 100 pi cubic centimeter if the right triangle is revolved about the side 12 centimeter. Now let us consider the reverse situation, another situation. Suppose you see, now what is the other situation? See, suppose the same question, look at, this is 12, this is 5, this is 13, okay. Now instead of revolving, see, instead of revolving the right triangle, try to understand. Instead of revolving the right triangle about 12 cm, suppose we will revolve it about 5 cm. Okay, suppose we will revolve it. We will revolve the right triangle about this side, BC, not AB. So what will happen? See children, if I revolve, look at, I am drawing once again. This is 12, this is 5, and this is 13. Now if you, when you revolve, this is A, B, and C. So when you revolve about this side, what will happen? You will get a cone like this, you see. The solid generated will be like this. Look at. Look at. This is the center. Now, that means, what I mean to say, that if right triangle ABC whose length of sides are 5, 12 and 13, if it is revolved about the, if it is revolved, if the right triangle is revolved, about the side BC or the base of the right triangle, then what will happen? You will get a cone like this. See, look at the figure. You will get a cone like this. Whose radius of base? You see, in the previous case, when we revolve the right triangle about the perpendicular, what happened? Height became equal to perpendicular and base became equal to what? Radius. But here, the situation is something different. When we revolve this right triangle ABC about BC, what will happen? Now see, this has become the height. This is the height of the cone generated. And the perpendicular has become the what? Radius of base. Okay. So what I mean to say, children, if number two, if right triangle ABC is revolved about which side? BC. About BC equal to say 5 cm. Then whatever cone is generated or produced, its height will be equal to, then height of cone will be equal to your BC, which is 5 cm. And your radius of base, see, this is the cylinder, this is the base. This is the base, look at. So this is the radius. So radius of base will be equal to your AB. That means it is 12 cm, okay? So when we revolve a right triangle about the base becomes the what? Height. The base becomes the height and perpendicular becomes the radius of base. Now you can easily find what is the volume, see? So volume of cone generated. So volume of cone will be equal to 1 by 3 pi r square h again. You put the formula 1 by 3 pi. What is the value of r? It is 12 square. And what is the value of h? It is 5. Now you do the calculation. It is how much? 144. So 1 by 3 pi into 144 into 5. Now do the cancellation. 3, 4 is 12. 12, 2. 3, 8. You see. So it is 240 pi. See. Cubic centimeter.
So what did you notice, children? In both the cases, you see, in the first case, we revolve the right triangle about the perpendicular. In that case, the perpendicular became the height of the cone generated and your base became the radius. So we got some volume. We got the volume of cone how much? 100 pi cubic centimeter. But when we revolve the same right triangle about the base, this base of the right triangle became the radius of, this base of the right triangle, it became the height and the perpendicular became the what? It became the radius of base. So accordingly, definitely the volume will vary. So in this case, we saw that the volume is changing. Okay, in both the cases, you are getting a cone. That means from here it is proved that whenever we revolve a right triangle about any one side, maybe perpendicular, maybe base, also we can revolve it. We can revolve the right triangle about the hypotenuse. It will be taught in class 10, children. So,
So when a right triangle is revolved about the perpendicular or the base, always a cone is generated. Only the radius of base and the height will change. Okay, so that you have to understand only. Then only you can do problem. In this case, we saw how the value of R and H changes when it is revolved about the right triangle is revolved about the perpendicular or it is revolved about the base. Okay, children, I hope whatever I discussed problem. Whatever two problems I discussed, you must have understood. I also discussed what is spherical cell, what is hemispherical cell, etc. in detail, and I am sure you must have understood. So, with this, we came to the end of the chapter, that is surface area and volume. Okay? So, we shall discuss another new chapter, statistics, in the next class. And I am sure whatever I discussed in this chapter and today also, my dear students, they must have understood. If at all it is true, children, I would like to say that you please hit the like button and subscribe my channel, okay? So that I shall be encouraged to discuss more and more things in my upcoming classes, okay? Thank you.